19 degrees this morning. We're at dance class. As I was sitting here, after about 20 minutes or so, my wife came back out, and she says, they're selling this t-shirt in there, you know, that has the dance class name and the name of the students on it. So I said, okay, you know, how much? $15. Keep in mind, this is a t-shirt for a six-year-old. $15. So I said, well, take her over to the t-shirt, let her take a look at it, see if she likes it, and ask her if she'd rather have that or some new books or something, which I thought was a fair way of approaching the $15 t-shirt conundrum. I started in a different direction, but then my batteries ran out, so after the switch, I thought I would, use a different angle here. Last night, wife and I are watching, the fuck was on? It was after the Terminator. We watched the Terminator every now and then, the Sarah Connor Chronicles. Numbers. Yeah, Numbers was on. It's a decent show. And I see these flashing lights outside the windows. And eventually, when they don't go away, I get up, you know, I look out the window, and in front of the neighbor's house, there's this vehicle that appears to be one of those lunch trucks, you know, with like the aluminum sides and all that, except it's loaded with flashing lights. And it's I couldn't tell what the fuck it was. It looked like a cross between a police vehicle and a fire vehicle. And it was in front of the neighbor's house diagonally across the street. Oddly enough, there were also two cop cars there. So I watch, and the two cop cars leave, and this funky vehicle is still there. Then an ambulance comes up, and some dude sort of like trots out of the house. He doesn't go to the ambulance. He goes halfway up the street, and he meets a couple of his friends who are like walking there. And so then they come back, and then the dude goes back into the house. And then, you know, this is like 5 minutes past, 10 minutes past, nothing's going on. I can't figure out what the hell's going on across the street. It's sort of a demonstration. I mean, that same house where the rescue team responded to last night, we got a call from some lawyer in Texas saying, well, you know, these people live across the street from you. We were hoping you could help us in an investigation of them, some fraud investigation or something. Surely you must know them. And it's like, the only neighbors we really knew passed away. That was John and Lucy, who were right next to us. Great neighbors, best neighbors you could ever want. And the rest of the neighborhood, we barely know. And this particular people that they were inquiring about, we didn't know at all. So some sort of shenanigans going on. I mean, just the way it is when you live in a poor neighborhood, every now and then you see the sirens outside your window and some crazy shit goes down. Coming here, the dance class with the $15 t-shirts, everybody who comes here in their new minivans and all that, they make more money than me, by far. I mean, wherever I go, it's a damn safe bet that anybody you pick makes more money than me. So, you know, I was talking about this with John Ain't Right a few weeks ago. When you're frugal, because you have to be frugal, and you go shopping at, like, Salvation Army and Goodwill and stuff like that, people tend to look down on you. They don't have to say anything. You know, you can just tell sometimes. You know, the people who like to buy themselves new clothes all the time. The assholes. The bourgeoisie, as far as I'm concerned. Although they would never call themselves that. Oh no, to them, bourgeoisie is an even higher class of people who make even more money. Right? Fucking slippery, shitty steps of a crappy capitalist ladder, right? Anyway, we were talking, and we also got onto the subject of this video that John did that I thought was really good a while ago, about how if more people actually saw how their food was prepared, and maybe actually grew some of it themselves, or, God forbid, slaughtered some of it themselves, you know, they would have a better understanding of what it takes to get it to the market, and the appreciation, you know. Too many people think, you know, meat comes in little styrofoam and saran wrap packages. That's not how meat originally came in. That's how we put it, right? And then Chartres did a video and a blog about Victory Gardens. Remember those? Started in wartime, the big push to have a Victory Garden. It's great, you know, it's something I should do, which I rarely do, you know, just plant some stuff. Usually every year about all I get to do is like some onions. Because I have onions that have already sprouted in the fridge, you know, so it's easy to put them in a planter outside and I'll do that. So separated, right? Is that progress that we're so separated from the land and working? You know, this economy, the way it could be going, the people who can grow their own food to some extent are going to have a leg up. John always tells me how good squirrels taste. I got plenty of squirrels, man, but I never tasted them. If I were to, you know, get a squirrel, trap it, kill it, skin it, cook it up, wouldn't have to buy hamburger that day or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Getting back to what I was saying when the batteries ran out. My friend Brian, his marriage went on the rocks, and he was hiding a lot of the bills from his wife because he felt she experienced undue stress. That was his story. I think he was never good with money, and he squandered a lot of money that should have gone to bills. But anyway, she eventually has enough of it, you know, because the habitual lying is just basically deception, and it tends to increase if it's not addressed. You know, the more lies you buy from a habitual liar, the more comfortable they're going to feel lying to you. Anyway, this is all in an old blog I did around the end of October. And I was thinking, he spent 6 months with us, and he lied about all sorts of things during that time. This is back in 2004. And we haven't had anybody living with us since then. You know, he lived in the basement, yeah, had a bed set up there and stuff. Why don't I have a contest, considering how the economy is, for a free room and board for like a month, or should I say up to a month, for anybody who wants to enter this contest, right? No bills. No housing bills. No food bills. If you want to incur, you know, entertainment and ancillary expenses on your own, well, you'll have to cover that. But if I were to cover no housing bills and no food bills for up to a month, I wonder if any folks out there would be interested. Consider it like a retreat, a getaway. We could have a contest, you know, you could submit your video application. Wife and I could be the judge. Just an idea. And I would guarantee you 2 hours a day of time with me. Hey, some prize, right? You could have all the time you want to read books, which is what I encouraged my friend to do. All the time you want to explore the countryside of central New York, if you brought your own car, if you arrived by, you know, train, a bus or something, then you'd have to be willing to conform to my rather hermetic, is that the right word? Hermit's schedule. I'm just toying with the idea. This isn't like the announcement of it or anything. If it actually goes forward, I'll do a blog, and a blog specifically devoted to this contest. Maybe I can get Helmut to help me with some of the narration. You know, he has his own getaway in Germany. Alright.
Gilligan, you bastard! If you troll me, I'll start trolling you again.